Nice. Thank you, April. It's the 67th show by the Tucson Gem and Mineral Society, bringing, you know, those gems and sellers from all over the world.
Now on your side, Sina Giuliano is live with a sneak peek of what visitors could unearth this year as they scan through everything. Good morning, Sina.
Good morning. Yeah, in the Tucson Convention Center behind me, it's literally packed with tables, vendors, display cases as they get ready for the show to open today, with hundreds and thousands of gems ready for visitors to come and see over the next couple of days for their 67th show.
For the last 30 years, PG Law and her parents pack up all their gems and handcrafted jewelry and come to Tucson.
We're old school. We came to do this show when it was like, I don't know, 30 dealers with a bunch of card tables out. So we've watched this show grow into what it is now.
Even before Law began designing all the jewelry for the family business, the shows were a big part of her life.
Well, it's family business, so I guess I grew up coming to these shows when I was a kid.
The Tucson Gem and Mineral Society's Peter McGaw says this show is a major part of the industry.
Probably at least 20 different countries around the world, in addition to the United States and Arizona.
So when the show was canceled last year, selling the gems online was difficult.
Like, you know, I was able to sell online, but customers want to come see it in person. They want to try it on, and like, when you put on a piece of jewelry, you feel a connection to it.
McGaw says not only is the show important to the vendors, but also to Tucson as a whole.
This is our gift to the community every year, to sort of make people understand how important these are to Arizona, to Tucson, and to the world.
So if you're coming to the show, the organizers ask that you follow all COVID-19 safety precautions, including wearing your mask. But there is food for visitors and vendors available if you come to the show. Sending it back to you, Lydia and Jose.